I had stuff majorly on the outside and still do. I have a lot of external wheelchair stuff. I've got the actual wheelchair, got the messed up hand, the paralyzed face, physical stuff. What's interesting in seeing their stories and thinking through my own story, I realized we all have invisible wheelchairs. We all have so much stuff inside of us that is disabled. The disabilities in us all that are really something I kind of get a pass on. You know, I've got this external wheelchair. You see, people know I've been through a lot. Treat her with care. But nobody sees that when you've got a big old invisible wheelchair inside of you, which, side note, we all do, honestly, every one of us. I made a list of a few of mine for you to help free you up to think about yours. I have major sleep issues and vivid, dangerous night terrors. I have horrific anxiety about my son's emotional and physical well-being. I have a deep fear of rejection. I'm a tragic people pleaser. I have mommy shame for working full-time and traveling so much. I have doubts about being a good mom. I have marital stress. I have had my whole life the fear of being too much, and yet somehow still never enough. And it is deeply debilitating. I feel like I'm dramatic and loud and gonna overwhelm you. And yet I'm also never gonna measure up. And deep down I'm like, are they even gonna like me? Are they automatically gonna hate me? And it is just so messed up, y'all. And I don't know, I think there is such a freedom in seeing, like, that's so wrong. That is so the opposite. And those are invisible wheelchairs, but they are nonetheless stuff that I don't need to be bound by, but instead be freed by. Let me explain. My wheelchair is seen as what the world would call wheelchair bound. You probably heard that, wheelchair bound. Well, I'm screaming a different tune. I'm wheelchair free. And what I mean by that is that I sit in a big wheelchair all the time. But actually, that wheelchair is my avenue to freedom. That wheelchair is what enables me to do my life, to go where I want to go, to do what I want to do. The wheelchair is not holding me back. It's helping fuel me, push me forward. And the same is true in all of our disabilities. Similar to me waking up to that reality with my wheelchair, how can we, in all of our disabilities, ponder and recognize, well, this is in my story, and this is in my story, and that is in my story, but how are the avenues that God is using for my freedom? We know Psalm 16:6 is true, that the boundary lines have fallen in pleasant places. Somehow, the stuff in here is seriously good, seriously worth celebrating. So how can I learn to see it, to ponder it, to wake up to it, instead of just wanting to pray it away? I want to bring it in close. And I want to honor the Lord as I champion this stuff that I never would have chosen in a million years. I see so clearly that in this hard place we all find ourselves in, when we can recognize that God has assigned us to this, we can celebrate it. We can rejoice in it because we see God's goodness is here. He's taking care of me. And I choose to be a joy rebel. I choose to rebel joyfully. And honestly, I choose to disrupt the deep lie. And I mean lie. The deep lie, the joy can only be found in a pain-free life. let me say it again. You get to be a part of disrupting the lie that joy can only be found in a pain-free life.